underneath the camera. Oh, yes. Oh, I don't know how big, but it didn't look small.
Underwater cameras. Something I wanted to talk about for a while, but I haven't yet. So we're making the video right now. I know ice fishing videos to come soon, I promise. I'm headed south tomorrow for a few days. I'll be back to start testing out the hard water. But until then, it's one of my most asked questions probably on YouTube or social media is, what kind of underwater cameras do I use and how do I record with them? I'm gonna go over that right meow.
Here it comes. Come on. Yes, I got him. Big fish. I got him to eat.
That moment right there is probably one of the most epic moments I've captured on the underwater camera. And I captured that right here with the Aqua Vu HD7i Pro. Now, how did I capture all that? Recording devices. I'll cover the whole recording device first. This is what I use, is an Aver Media 2. I don't even know if I'm pronouncing it correctly. Anyways, comes in a box just like this. It's used for gaming, basically, to live stream Twitch, YouTube, etc. But what it does is it can power into the Aqua Vu cameras. This is the HD10i, and this, like I said, this is the HD7i Pro. I'll talk a little bit more about those first, but this right here, this allows you to plug in here with an HDMI cord into the back of the unit, and then you have to power it with some kind of like battery pack right here. This is like a Mophie battery pack. What I've also been using is the Dakota Lithium power pack right there, but it's pretty simple. Plugs in through an HDMI port into here, into the unit. It comes with it doesn't come with a memory card, but you have to use a little memory card in here. I run like a 64 gig or a 128 gig card in here. A lot of times it'll record for the whole day. And it's kind of basic setup. Once you start using it, the instructions are all in there of what to use it and how to use the type of thing, but it'll basically tell you the different types of blinking lights. But you power that in through there, through the HDMI cable in the back, and you record all day. I'll give you one piece of advice. I'm not going to talk about how to do it or whatnot. All the instructions are there, but don't unplug this unit straight from here without stopping your recording first. If you unplug your power source, the last clip that you were recording will not be there. It will be gone. And sometimes I've had this thing like record for like 7 hours straight, and it's like one great big file. So what I'll do sometimes, if I catch a great big fish or any fish have some action, I'll click it at the end of the action, and I know that little section is going to be safe, and I'll restart another file just in case my battery pack dies or I run out of power. I just say the same thing, or accidentally disconnect it, something like that. So Mophie battery pack, Aver Media. I'll leave the links below for Amazon where to get it, but like I said, it's right here. This little box right there is what it looks like. You can use other recording devices, I'm sure, but this is what I found that works for me. So power supply, recording device, HDMI cord comes with it. You'll need a power cord to be able to run this. So that's what I use to capture pretty much all of my underwater footage. Like I said, the 10 and the 7. The 7 is probably more useful to people that are going to be moving around a little bit more. The 10 comes in really handy in a permanent shelter, or if you're going to be camped out in a spot for a few days. I tend to use my 7 more now than the 10, but the 10 is a little bit bigger screen, so if you're going to be staring at it all day and not moving around very much, definitely the 10. You're not going to get all day out of these cameras. With the Aqua Vu 7, you're getting probably about 5 to 6 hours. With the 10, you're getting probably 2 to 3 hours. But if you can hook them up to an external battery source, I carry a car battery around with me that I use to run lights in my shelter, record camera batteries as I go. They come with a little device like this that allows you to hook up to external battery and hooks right into the back. So external batteries for sure are going to make things last longer. You can take them apart and you can put in like a Dakota Lithium battery, which will extend your battery life for it. I know the 7, if you put in one of those batteries, you can get all day on it. So that is what I'm hoping to put in one of these cameras this year. Those two together, the cameras and the Dakota Lithiums, the power pack right there, they're definitely a deadly combination. With the camera, another good accessory right here is the little tripod. I think they call, I'm lost for words what they call them. I'll put it right here on the screen. Mopod, something like that. And that basically allows you to put your camera cord in here, and then it has a remote that you can click and it can turn your camera around to pan around and get the perfect angle. I find when you're recording a lot of times that even when you're using the remote, that when you press it, it jumps a little bit too far. So you can just take it and you can just turn a little bit by hand too, like that. It's not gonna hurt it. Liner all up for you. So yes, the underwater cameras, great tool for learning how the fish are reacting, what's going on. I've captured some amazing moments on here. Like I said, the lake trout video that or the lake trout clip that I showed here a little bit earlier, mostly lake trout so far. I have some awesome underwater stuff that I've captured. Another option though, if you're not looking for something as big and bulky and you still wanna do some recording, is the Micro Revolution 5.0 Pro. Now there's a Revolution 5.0 and there's a Revolution 5.0 Pro. The Pro is a recording device that's right here on the unit itself here. You just press the little record button and it'll capture and record right onto the unit, and then you plug it into your computer after to take it off. This is really handy for scouting around when I'm going to a lake that I just want to see what's going on down there for structure or what kind of fish I might be marking. This thing is like the cat's meow for sure. I like to have kind of both with me at the same time, but this thing's so handy. It literally, the camera, once you come out, when it comes out and you start dropping it down, you get down to your length, right? And then say, now you want to pick it back up at the end of the time. Look at this little handy wheel on it. That's probably one of the biggest things with underwater cameras, is the time that it takes to deploy them, bring them back in. It's time consuming. So if you can make something that's, you know, quick for you, I definitely recommend these. And you can get the one to record on, which is the Pro. But if you just want to get them and not make videos, but the Revolution 5.0 would be the one to get. There isn't a big difference between the 10 and the 7, obviously besides screen size. The Pro model to the iSeries model, there's a couple different features that the Pro model has that the iSeries doesn't, but the iSeries is a great camera for sure. Both of these models will get the job done for you. It's just a matter of what you want to use them for. Bouncing around a lot, small little camera. Moving around a little bit, where you don't maybe have access to some external battery source, the 7 I'd recommend. A wheelhouse or somewhere where you're gonna be camped for a couple of days and you have a big car battery with you, the 10. That's kind of how I choose when I go for a trip what I'm going to do. You always learn cool new things with the underwater cameras that you're not gonna learn with anything else. It's definitely a tool that I take with me every time I go out on the ice. Sometimes I use it, sometimes I don't, but when you do need it, it's there, it's accessible, and they're super easy to use. And honestly, the quality of the cameras these days is unbelievable. High definition footage I can record to show you guys. It's so cool. So there's a little bit about some underwater cameras, short little video. Like I said, more ice fishing videos coming soon. If you have any questions about the cameras, leave them in the comments below in this video right here. We'll see you soon. Don't forget, get outside.